Drayton Manor, located in Staffordshire, England, began life as an inland pleasure resort, expanding from its humble beginnings to become the theme park we know today. Discover the fascinating story of this family fun park. A manor house had stood on the site that is now Drayton Manor since the 11th century. Owners constantly changing before the estate was purchased by the Peel family in 1790. Under this ownership, the original manor was demolished, with a grand mansion constructed in its place by two-time Prime Minister Robert Peel. The house was demolished in 1926, with only the clock tower still remaining. The land was later requisitioned during World War II to use as an army training ground. Following the war, George and Vera Bryan borrowed money and purchased the land for £12,000 in 1949. Their purchase included the 17 army huts still remaining on the site. The couple already had some experience in the UK leisure industry. George's father was a manufacturer of coin-operated amusement machines, while Vera's father owned California and England Pleasure Park, a major inspiration for the early years of Drayton Manor Park. The site was overgrown, covered with brambles, the lakes filled with rubbish. Work began to transform the site, clearing the vegetation, buying second-hand equipment, and demolishing all but one of the old army huts. When the new Drayton Manor Park opened Easter 1950, it included a small restaurant, tea room, three hand-operated rides, some rowing boats, and a Dodgems, purchased second-hand for £500. In the early days, visitors came to relax in the grounds, with rides being a secondary attraction. Many of the early fairground rides were built in-house, including the popular Snake Train, which was built from post-war army surplus. It wasn't until the late 1950s that the budget was available to purchase 13 new rides, one of which was a 19th century carousel, which is still operating at the park today. The zoo at Drayton Manor originally started in 1957 in a bid to give visiting school children something educational. The first animals were monkeys, chimps and penguins, and the exhibits have expanded over the years to include a farm area, the reptile house, and life-size fiberglass dinosaurs. The tea room was redeveloped into a ballroom for the 1960s, attracting big-name acts of the day, and this spurred on further expansion of the inland pleasure resort. The first major ride at Drayton Manor arrived in 1964. The chairlift was constructed, costing the park £27,000. Its installation also necessitated a hastily constructed roof for the gentlemen's toilets, which at the time were open-topped. Following a visit to Walt Disney World in 1975, Vera and George Bryan realised that ongoing investment was needed if they wanted to continue to become a major player in the UK leisure industry. They knew they could never be another Disney, but they could borrow their ideas. Drayton's very own Jungle Cruise was opened in 1976 and was clearly influenced by its American counterpart. The first true white-knuckle ride was installed at Drayton Manor in 1981. The log flume was located close to the lake, providing visitors a soaking splashdown. Close by, the jumbo jet roller coaster was installed. This Schwarzkopf ride was the first full-size roller coaster to be installed at the park. These attractions kick-started a ride expansion, with new or updated attractions being installed at the theme park every year since. The jumbo jet was replaced by the Python in 1985. Bringing the first inverting roller coaster to Drayton Manor, and the ride would eventually be rethemed to become the Klondike Gold Mine. For the 1990 season, the park opened its iconic pirate adventure. This indoor boat ride was clearly inspired by another of Disney's successful attractions, Pirates of the Caribbean. The installation of Pirate Adventure pushed the park to construct even more custom attractions. Plans were put in place for two brand new rides on a shared site. For 1993, Splash Canyon Rapids would open, and the following year would be joined by stand-up roller coaster Shockwave. Shockwave put Drayton Manor on the map and became one of three iconic rides that would open in the UK year of the roller coaster. As the park continued to expand, it would not shy away from innovation. In 1996, The Haunting was introduced, becoming one of the first Vekoma Madhouse installations. 1999 saw Drayton Manor replace the ageing log flume with Stormforce 10, and its custom ride system. 2004 brought the only X-Car coaster to the UK. G-Force featured lap bar restraints, terrifying riders with an inverting lift hill. Drayton Manor had always catered to the family market, but for 2008 opened Thomasland. This heavily themed area featured rides and attractions based on long-running children's television series, Thomas and Friends. The land even features its own junior roller coaster, Troublesome Trucks, as well as a narrow gauge railway. Thomasland has further expanded over the last decade, adding to the family appeal of the theme park. A 150-bedroom hotel was opened in 2011. This accommodation complemented the next-door theme park and featured Thomas-themed bedrooms. By 2020, Drayton Manor was still in family ownership, having been run by three generations of the Bryan family. Following storm damage and the COVID-19 pandemic, cash flow became a problem and the park entered administration. It was subsequently purchased by the Looping Group, who already owned attractions across Europe. The Looping Group would start a multi-year renovation of the theme park, reopening the closed river rapids as part of Adventure Cove, and creating the new Vikings-themed area. With plans for the future underway, the refresh of the park continues, with Drayton Manor looking to provide family fun for years to come.